the cockpit country, an environmental, cultural, and historical asset which the people and the government of Jamaica value greatly.
The cockpit country is the country's largest water bank, the largest store of Jamaica's underground water, and it feeds many rivers. We, in seeking to protect the cockpit country, we examined the areas that have the feature of the cockpit, and then we looked at areas that depend on it, such as the forests, and we looked as well as the biodiversity that lives on it, the animals and the plants that live in that forest, and we protected that as well. And then we examined the issue of hydrology, meaning the water that is related to that area flows into the area and flows out of the area, the sinkholes and the various caves and crevices through which water enters and seeps underground, and we protected those as well.
That protection was necessary because the cockpit country has been under threat from human activity, destructive farming techniques, improper garbage disposal, and overgrazing by animals are but a few of the actions that have negatively impacted this area. Thankfully, the government has stepped in by way of a protective boundary around the area. The Forestry Department is undertaking a ground-truthing mission to align these boundaries on the proposed map with the actual landmarks. Ground-truthing is taking place over 76,000 hectares of land across the mountainous regions of five parishes in the area designated as the protected cockpit country. The process, which started in 2018, is expected to be completed in 2020.
That boundary will be enshrined in law. And within that boundary, there will be no mining. And within that boundary as well, certain agricultural practices will be banned, such as slash and burn, the use of dangerous chemicals. And it will be a regulated space to protect that water bank of Jamaica and to protect the forests that grows in the cockpit country, and to generally protect that area as a national ecological park for Jamaica.
Consideration is also being given to the historic significance that the cockpit country bears to all Jamaicans, especially the Maroons.
There are areas around the cockpit country that are thought to be part of what is culturally considered the cockpit country. The cockpit country was where the Maroons lived. And it is where the British could not go. It is where the British were defeated in battle and had to see the cockpit country and walk around it, creating what is historically called a ring road around the cockpit country. And in fact, the Maroons were able, one of the probably only peoples who have defeated the British within this area and had a peace treaty. They were literally an independent state within Jamaica during the time of slavery.
This is our legacy, a section of Jamaica that spans across two parishes, Trelawney and St. Elizabeth. The government of Jamaica will be continuing their fight to protect one of our greatest assets.
And I want it to be absolutely clear to the Jamaican citizens that this government is the government of the environment. So we are not the government that will trade off economic benefit for environmental cost. That is not this government. So yes, we hear the complaints. Yes, we hear all that is happening on social media and what is being said. But I want to reassure the Jamaican people that this government will be responsible with our environment.